My name is Emily, and my poem is called A Poem That I Didn't Try Loud Enough On. Dear perfectionism, is this poem cliched? I've seen many versions of dear, insert word here, but it's always written in the first person. Does that make me unoriginal? A burden? Should I get rid of my words, scrunch up the paper? Let rough pencil lead me to erase and leave me with fragments of what I once wrote? See, these are the things that go through my head, and I'd prefer to simply write a poem instead, if that's okay with you. But it's not. You decide to rock the clock, tip the boat, tip me out, to pull me into a spiral of mad panic in a mindset I can't escape from. Can I do anything right if I can't write a simple damn poem? If I can't write the damn poem, what can I do? Sure, I could write a crappy first draft and then edit it and progress to something beyond that, but can you cope with that perfectionism? Apparently not, no. I should write perfect from the get-go and then somehow progress to more than perfect, an unobtainable state. They say reach for the stars, but this is something far beyond that. I've written this poem a million times, adding more alliteration, adding more rhymes, and then panicking over if this line sounds cheesy. When I should be writing from the heart, I'm writing purely from techniques, conventions, because that's what's in the rubric, and that's what you perfectionism want from this. You don't want a poem with heartfelt meaning, you want a poem with rhythm and rhyme. A poem that gets good grades, a perfect poem. A poem that almost hurts every time I try and force it out, and I force and force and force and force and spew, leaving a mess staining the pristine page. A mess of derogatory terms that I'm giving my own work, a mess of stress-induced headaches, a mess of sleepless nights, a mess, a mess, a mess. Not a disease, not an illness. There's no excuse for me not to treat myself with kindness or politeness. You're a mindset. You're me, you're part of me. My head, my thoughts, my words. Yet you're not the voice of an oppressor I can't run from. It's me I can't run from because I follow myself everywhere I go, critiquing everything I do. You're just a thought process trying to trap me in a never-ending loop of negativity. A derailed train that I need to get back on the tracks. So, do I have a chance in a battle against myself?